So I'm leaving the names off of these FactNet posts because people can get sidetracked by names. It conjures up visions for them or ill will. And I just figure if something is a truth, it's a truth. Doesn't matter who said it or shared it. And so this first one is exactly what happened to me. I had been as a GI in the Philippines in a serviceman's home. I had been putting what I thought was tithe into the basket, to the offering basket. I just pitch money in there. I don't know how much. And it wasn't until a couple came to take over for the Ashmores, Ted and Jean Keys, from what I understood at the time, they had just graduated Bible school. And within the first week or two, easily, near the end of 1989, he had been teaching in a Bible study about tithe. And about the right way to do it, and how much it was, and how you were supposed to. He showed us how to fill out the envelope. And he spoke with me personally afterwards, and because I felt convicted. I always felt convicted. And he told me that I owed back tithe if I hadn't been giving a certain amount from the gross amount of my wages, then I was in danger of going to hell, and I owed back tithe. So Ted and I sat there, and we figured out how much I probably owed, a guesstimate, and I had to pay back tithe each week from my pay. So I paid the 10%, I paid what he said I owed, which I think was, I don't know, I don't want to start pulling numbers out of my butt or out of thin air, but I'm going to have to check this out, but I want to say it wasn't 10% the back tithe. It was that plus more, because you owed. It was like a penalty with the IRS, sort of, only you owed God. But Ted was happy to take the money on his behalf. And so in that last little screen there, what I did was I wrote out an example. So between 1989 and December 2005, we left the church, our family, on January 1st, 2006. So all that time, we not only paid 10% of gross wages, but Ted taught us, and so Ted taught us what we were supposed to do was not just pay 10% on the gross wages, but we were supposed to pay 10% on anything that was added unto us, such as someone takes you to lunch and you figure out your portion and then you tithe 10% on that. If you received a big bag of gifts from Santa Claus, you're supposed to figure out for each one. When my family would send us things in the mail, I figured for shipping and approximate cost of things, and I tithed. I'm tired. I tithed 10% on that. And then you add up all the 10% amounts, and that's what we paid in tithe. And you put it in an envelope, and you put your name on it. And that way of doing things was never disputed whenever I shared that that's what we were doing when I went to Bible college or Bible school. It's not a college. And so I'm wondering if that still goes on. If it does not, why not? Either it was God directed all along or it wasn't. And so it's just one more brick in the wall.